All right. Hello, everyone, and now welcome to my second game for today. X-Lord spawning over here on the top left-hand side of the map, placing down an Altar of Darkness crypt, and where there is that necropolis. No big surprises. Good game. Good luck. Have fun. Both sides being well-mannered. This game is from the Warcraft Gold League 2020 Summer Season Western Qualifier. Yes, say that three times slowly. And well, the game might already be over. It's a follow, by the way. It was a follow. Thank you for the follow. I always appreciate it. If you do like what you see, definitely consider hitting follow. If you don't like what you see, be a well-mannered person and just leave. There's other people here on the internet that you can enjoy for good content on Twitch and all of these other streaming channels. If you're not looking, I don't know. A lot of people seem to think that everyone wants to hear their opinion. 25 plus equals 3? I don't know what that you're referencing, metaphysics. Anyways, it is going to be an Archmage going up against, I believe, it is going to be a Crypt Lord. All right, so the novelty of Crypt Lord first has, well, started to go out the window as, I believe a lot of people are showing that Crypt Lord first actually has the highest win rate for undead right now. So with that high win rate, we'll see how exactly that Crypt Lord is going to be used. Being able to swarm your opponent's units early on, having access to impale, a very strong AoE, a stun at a range, very, very powerful indeed. Footman gonna go ahead and get trained up, as we are looking at one single footman now running out across the field in order to do a little bit of scouting. All right, left-handed footman on his way out across the field here. All it takes to be a footman in the human army is to be left-handed, and I guess that's a little bit strange and odd considering, at least the story of human castles in Europe that I know of, everyone was right-handed, and you would actually design your staircases and spiral staircases and things of that nature in a way where if you are defending, attacking from the top of the castle down, being right-handed had an advantage. Anyways, we are looking at the Crypt Lord. He did unsummon that Altar of Darkness. He does have a sacrificial skull, and we are now going to be taking a look at a large number of units just making their way out. Maybe you can use both hands at the same time. Well, that would make more sense if you are ambidextrous. Then that makes you a good footman, because even if you lose one arm, if you aren't suffering from shock, you can fight with your other arm. Maybe that footman's name is Inigo Montoyas. Anyways, Crypt Lord getting ready to engage. Ziggurat, Haunted Goldmine, all here ready to go. I've always wanted to make a Princess Bride reference in the middle of my cast. Hopefully that did not fall on deaf ears. Anyways, Archmage sitting at level 2 has 445 mana, but down to 112 already. So that is one of the downsides of getting that pendant of energy early on. If you got it after you cast, got it before you cast your second water elemental, you end up having a lot more mana. Alright, Crypt Lord got its impale improved, so it sounds like TC, but with Keeper of the Grove summons. Torrent Chieftain, there is that impale. The stun does not last nearly as long, as we're going to see a quick surround. Wow, quick surround on this army against Blade. You can take a look how many units are just already there, and that Forest Troll Shadow Priest being forced to try and fight back against all of these units here. It looks like one Forest Troll Shadow Priest will get taken down, and there it goes, finally getting taken down there. Meanwhile, towers are getting constructed. We are looking at a Ziggurat here. There was, I thought I saw a little bit of healing onto that from that Crypt Lord, but the Crypt Lord now going to have some serious trouble, as we are now going to try and engage here. All right, Ziggurat going to turn into another tower here, as the Beetles are going to try and fight back. And who would have thought in my years of casting on Echo Isle, it is the undead with the fast expansion and the human trying to stop the fast expansion attempt. Archmage gonna go ahead and try and fight back all of these units here. Scout towers, arcane towers trying to get constructed. Ghoul is gonna try and engage. Scout tower about to get, well, canceled, I believe, as the water elemental trying to back away. All right, there it goes. It is ending up taken down once more as the Crypt Lord needs to get a little bit more blight underneath him in order to stay alive. Scout tower ends up getting taken down. One scout tower down. We are looking at a Nerubian tower getting ready to engage as well. I really dislike the movie. Wow, you disliked The Princess Bride? Oh, many years later I watched it in English and loved it. Okay, all right, you gotta come back and say that. All right, anyways, Crippler getting ready to engage. There are a whole bunch of peasants here, perhaps on auto repair, ready to repair all of this damage as it comes online. This is going to be an expensive push for the human player. A couple of footmen could get taken down as well. If that ghoul gets taken down, or if that unit gets taken down, that would be important indeed, as the one guard tower actually up. So the guard tower gets up first, and it looks like a blade, if he wants to, he has all of these peasants already here. He will have a very well protected expansion if it stays up and running. Acolytes about to get taken out here. We are going to get a little bit of repairing. Arcane vault also being thrown in. And it looks like Exor trying to keep track, seeing if there is an expansion off over here. Sees there that there is not one, as the Tomb of Relics gets either canceled or destroyed. Could not tell. All right. Archmage should have been trying to attack down those Acolytes. Finishing off the Acolytes to get experience is actually important at this point and stage in the game, as we could be looking at perhaps, yes, an expansion attempt from Blade. Blade getting an expansion attempt right across over here. Acolyte getting taken down. There goes a couple of buildings as well. Footman could attack that Haunted Gold Mine to deny a bit of gold as the building is being unsummoned. But what is this? X-Lord saying, you know what, you take my expansion, I'll just go ahead and take yours as well. All right, we're gonna, and the big question now is whether or not this is gonna be scouted out by Blade. A major attack now underway inside the base of X-Lord. Graveyard needs to get rebuilt here. There are a couple of towers now getting added in as we are going into tier 2. All right, a bunch of ghouls are now also, or not ghouls, these little carrion beetles trying to get in some damage here, causing some problems. These guard towers here, this is a very, very fortified location, and that, well, Crypt Lord does not really stand a chance sticking around. It is going to come down to proper scouting by Blade to know that he does not have an advantage. And this is often the reason why any battle or any war is lost. Lack of information and overestimating your position. Any strategy game, that is perhaps one of the reasons why you lose the most, as the footmen are looking to engage, finishing off these ghouls inside. All right, meanwhile, beetles are playing a game of whack-a-mole, able to burrow themselves and then just constantly harass their opponent. Meanwhile, the Halls of the Dead already done. That is going to add in more cold towers here as the Archmage sits at level 4. More damage coming across multiple units. X-Lord's one Shadow Priest escapes away at 15 hit points as a Water Elemental ends up getting taken down. Crypt Lord continuing to fight. Beetles are just causing more problems. Are they just going to continue to get in damage onto those peasants? And yes, they are. Are they going to burrow again? And if they continue to burrow exactly like that, well, it is just going to be a major, major harassment. All right, there is that burrow once more. And more towers are getting added in. Crypt Lord doesn't have enough for an impale. Archmage trying to get away. Going to be able to buy that potion of healing as the Crypt Lord is now backing away again. All right, Crypt Lord. And X-Lord looking to fully saturate this gold mine, get some ziggurats as well. And we are looking at a 33 supply army going up against 40. Blade, however, not having the economic advantage that he thinks he has. All right, trying to go after that Archmage now. Archmage down to 80 hit points. Archmage trying to double back around. Oh, ring around as the Archmage does buy Boots of Speed as well, if you did not know. Oh, X-Lord getting caught. All right, Staff of Teleportation going to go ahead and get out of there without much of an issue. Rejoining in on the rest of the fight. Are we going to get perhaps a new hero, Ultra of Darkness, needing to be resummoned? All right, damage trying to get added in here. A couple of footmen could end up getting taken down. There is that, well, dispelling of that, Scroll of Regeneration for Scroll Shadow Priest doing his job, making sure that the Archmage does not get back up to full hit points. All right, hidden ninja expansion in Echo Isle. Where do you hide an expansion? Well, I guess you hide an expansion where your opponent's expansion is, as a water elemental quickly gets taken down there. You can prevent a building by just burrowing a beetle underneath it. Yeah, you can. There is a beetle sitting right there, and more guard towers coming in the way. Blade actually investing quite heavily into additional guard towers. We should be looking at a slaughterhouse soon. Obsidian statues would absolutely be critical in this fight here, and what Exlord needs to do is Exlord needs to make it look like he is running on one base. He does not want to make it, he does not want to tip his hand to his opponent to let him know that he is actually running on two bases as of yet. As soon as his army shows that, hey, you know what, I'm a little bit stronger than you think I should be, and I believe the Blade will figure out, hey, you know what, the jig is up, and he's going to be looking for that expansion. Graveyard about to be completed. There you go. Are we going to get that slaughterhouse now? Death Knight now out onto the field, ready to fight and engage, and that could be bad news for that Archmage. Archmage already running for the hills, doesn't like the thought or the possibility of ending up losing that Archmage due to hero nuking, as the Crypt Lord shows up and is going to fight as well. We should be getting up a slaughterhouse now. There goes that slaughterhouse. Exord now going into tier 3. Exord still having a large amount of gold, but the same can be said of Blade at this time and stage in the game, as he's going to be forced to, well, spend a lot of gold and time trying to macro back up. All right, and when I say macro, I really mean just, I'm actually mean tech and build units. He is currently behind. He is just now getting to tier 2. He doesn't have his second hero as of yet. Meanwhile, Exlord is already nearing tier 3, getting up his slaughterhouse, and he should be able to get some obsidian statues. Archmage perhaps going to try and scout over here to the bottom right and finally scout out this expansion. And Archmage is going to be like, what the heck, Exlord? What are you doing? Sees this. There's an expansion. And there's another slaughterhouse being built down across over here. Breath of Fire coming across. And are we going to perhaps see a scroll of town portal trying to engage? All right, acolytes trying to repair, damage getting added in as well. That is a spirit tower and a Nerubian tower, large amounts of damage coming across. Footmen just trying to dive on all in here, but the footmen really don't have that much damage, as Exlord shows up with that Crypt Lord, gets in a big impale. All right, footmen are now trying to retreat back again, more damage adding in. Acolyte continuing to repair as well. Panda could end up getting taken down pretty easily, as we're looking at the Brewmaster. There it goes. Panda Brewmaster now taken down. Obsidian Statue going to get added in here once more, as we are looking at the Death Knight now trying to, well, stay away or stay on Blight again. All right, Death Knight continuing to engage once more. There's a Death Ball saving up a low hit point ghoul, as the Obsidian Statue now back out onto the field and going to provide not only hit points but mana, as the Archmage gets picked up and dropped back onto the ground. Exlord taking a big advantage into this matchup here, as you're taking a look at, well, the units trying to engage here. Crypt Fiend could easily finish off a couple of low hit point footmen. Are we going to get to level 2 on the Death Knight? If we do, level 2 on Holy Aura would be a very big deal. Just get off a Death Coil onto one footman, and then you are able to chase. Water Elemental about to get taken down. There it goes. Level 2 on Holy Aura trying to lead the charge, but no, not anymore. You can't waste your supply just for that, right? Have you ever seen a situation like this? No, I have not. All right, Arya, just so you can take a look. Undead expansion, but at the... Or undead base, but at the expansion location, it's the human... Yes, I can see the lich. All right, I'm trying to show you something that never happens in a game, and you're like, oh, look, there's a level 1 lich. Come on, Arya, you need to focus on things that are important. No, well, the expansions are not in the right spot. Human expansion is underneath undead. Undead expansion is underneath human. Huh? Exactly. Well, it is good, and Exlord is the one who had that sneak attack. Anyways, Panda coming in with a Breath of Fire. Death Knight can come back across. Ring of Protection plus 3 picked up by that Crypt Lord, as both sides are going to fight again. 57 supply compared to now 45. Exlord has the economic advantage, not paying taxes, but at the same time, and also perhaps having the advantage of tech and hero level, as we're now looking to clear up the mercenary camp. But in comes a Creepjack. Panda is going to come in from the back. Only a level 1 Panda here. Obsidian Statue now going to go and turn into a Destroyer and fight their way back out. Lich does have the Orb of Corruption as well, as we're going to see that Water Elemental getting taken down. Crypt Lord wants to get to level 5, not going to be able to do so. Too many other heroes out on the battlefield. as a clause of attack +9, given picked up by the Death Knight and perhaps given to the Lich a little bit later. Yes, there are lots of beetles. Beetles are now very popular as the Crypt Lord is now a go-to hero for the undead army. Crypt Lord first. 57 supply going up against 71. Blade once again has the army advantage. And is it going to really translate? That is the question. Undead perhaps going to be able to devour magic and get a little bit more mana. Lich now getting up to level 2. Frost, oh, there is a quick impale. Are we going to see a Frost Nova? Yes, onto the Lich, or from the Lich onto the Archmage. Archmage gets Holy Light healing as the Archmage able to dodge out of that tough spot there with the Scroll of Town Portal. Units now looking to back away. Exlord using this opportunity as his opponent is retreating once again to try and level up that Crypt Lord. All right, we are looking at Flying Machines overhead. Death Knight now up to level 3. Army now able to make its way back over. And the Crypt Lord does have very, very important Scroll of Town Portal just in case the fight goes sideways. All right, Flying Machines are here, ready to go. Flying Machine trying to dive on in. Units are now trying to back up again. Death Knight retreating once more. We're looking at 59 supply compared to 72. Blade having the army advantage again, as they are looking for perhaps an engagement here, but with a level 5 Crypt Lord and a level 3 Death Knight going up against a level 4 Archmage and a level 1 Panda, level 1 Paladin. Yeah, all the heroes. There is a level 2 Lich. Yes, I know. I was getting to it. But someone keeps on interrupting me. Well, the level 2, I was talking about the two primary heroes first. All right, everyone's a critic, even your own family. All right, coming back down across over here on the bottom left. Oh, there was a spell steal on and control magic on these carrion beetles. Carrion beetles now going to go ahead and dive into the ground. What happens when the control magic comes to an end? Does it switch control or do they disappear? That's actually one something I wanted to watch. A burrowed carrion beetle, is it going to go ahead and go to blade? Nope, it disappears. All right, so control magic is a way of taking control of a carrion beetle, and then when the control magic comes to an end, it then disappears. That was actually a genius move by Exord with getting his opponent's expo. It is a genius move, completely outsmarted right there, and pretty much just lack of information or lack of foresight by Blade to scout his own expansion location. 73 supply going up against 78 now. A Destroyer going to try and devour some magic. Does exactly that as the units back up again. Yes, Arya? A player's force is under. You got to be more specific. These obsidian statues? Yes. Yep, they are the same design. The little destroyer, the little statue thing on the back is the destroyer, and it basically comes into the air and comes alive. He crept that expo himself with the Crypt Lord, I think. Yes, Metaphysics, you are right. X-Lord actually crept this expansion by himself, so that's one of the reasons why Blade didn't think to actually check out that location. Being able to have a hero with not much of an army be able to clear out that particular creep camp and have acolytes move all the way out across that map wasn't something that Blade was expecting at all. If Blade had actually crept out that expansion himself earlier, he would have thought to himself, you know what, I need to make sure that my opponent doesn't use that to his advantage and take out that creep camp. It was still a good move. It would be worse if it was scouted earlier. That is a risky play. X-Lord knew that he had to do some sort of play to get back into the game. And if you always play conservative, you are never ever going to win any sort of battles. Then again, Happy often does play conservative, but he just uses his advantages and his micro to win. So. Playing conservatively is not the way, is not a particular strategy. Sometimes you do need to take risks. Otherwise, your opponent is just going to understand and know too much of your particular strategy and be able to predict what you're going to do. Over here, gold mines looking like they're about to mine out about, 4 minutes, 3.5 minutes here, 4 minutes of mining here. Meanwhile, X-Lord still has a good amount of mining going on down over here. Over 10 minutes of mining. This one about 8 minutes of mining left, 7.5 minutes. As we're looking at, X-Lord creeping out. a relatively difficult creep camp, Lich will get to level 3. And the real problem right now is that Blade still has only 411 on his heroes. That's been the case of the game, lack of information with that 411 now showing up as well. All right, X-Lord getting level 3 on the Lich. Death Knight still sitting comfortably at level 3. Perhaps going to try to clear out that bottom left expand or left creep camp as well. Get the last bit of strong experience on the map before pushing into the next battle. But I think there's some delays with our responses. Some delays. I'm not quite sure why. Could be Twitch or something else. Well, we get a third game now that Aria is here and we have 25 plus viewers. Unfortunately, no. My daughter's sad. It is my other daughter's birthday, and someone is dropping off or delivering a bounce house. They are delivering a bounce house, and I do know. You keep on trying to interrupt me, Aria. That's very rude. Someone is delivering a bounce house, and I need to be there to answer the door, and it's going to happen. They said the delivery window is like 7:30 to 10 o'clock, so a huge delivery window. Not quite what I wanted, but I need to be ready for it. A quick impale across multiple units. Peasants melting them all down. Destroyer is quickly going to go ahead and try and put pressure onto the guard tower now. As you're taking a look, guard tower is just pushing back all of that damage. Are you taking the day off? No, I took the day off yesterday because I had to. I went to the doctors and they left the Tome of Knowledge. Happy birthday. Well, it's for my other daughter, and my other daughter isn't awake yet. Death Knight, Lich. Death Knight finally gets up to level 4, level 2 Unholy Aura for faster movement speed all across. Militia now being called back over. We are looking at only a minute, a little bit more gold in the gold mine there, and we're looking at, Abomination's ready to join in on the fight. Abomination's also bringing in some disease cloud. We'll see. Well, there goes one peasant as well. And we're looking at X-Lord, who is in absolute control of this game now. Has over 2,500 gold, soon to be 3,000, finishing off units, getting them all in transition. And, has the hero level and also has the economic advantage as well. He's going to be able to mine more gold from his gold mines. But can a Blade make a play out of this some way, shape, or form? There are knights. They do have sundering blades. They are going to be effective against those crypt fiends. Another sorceress pretty much getting caught in transit again. And unit after unit just falling time and time again. Panda still at level 1 after all this time. A major impale goes across the entire center portion as that destroyer get destroyed. All right, destroyer down to 400 hit points, losing all of those hit points rather quickly. Flying machines are trying to focus it down. It looks like it will finally get taken down. No, another impale picking them all up, dropping them back down as the destroyer continually getting healed by that Death Knight. Alright, more battle underway. 81 supply compared to 79. Battles are about the same. More impale picking up and dropping off the units. The destroyer constantly being able to devour magic and eating up the scroll of protection. And that slow was the reason why he did not fall. Destroyer didn't get destroyed after all, but Blade did, yeah. Blade ended up just melting and completely unsure of what to do. The hero levels ultimately making one of the biggest impacts overall, being able to have a 5-4-4 hero advantage over a 4-1-1. And you saw what that Crypt Lord was able to do with level 3 impale, multiple impales picking up and dropping off units, and then allowing the Frost Nova to do the necessary remaining damage. That was a cool game though. Never saw such expo situation on this map. Yep, I have never seen it either. Gotta say thanks for watching, thanks for listening. That's gonna be it for today. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you guys like what you saw, follow me here on Twitch. You'll know when I'm live. If you guys want to see more action, definitely check out YouTube as well. I literally have thousands upon thousands of videos for your viewing pleasure, some of them better than others, as I've been casting for over 10 years. And thanks for watching, thanks for listening, and hope you guys enjoyed it.